Morning students, how are you all? Are you all keeping fine? Yes, good. So students, in the last video class we completed the chapter 4 of grammar, isn't it? Today we will start the chapter 6 of your English course book. Chapter 6 of your English course book will start. Because this chapter, which had to complete in the month of September, but we couldn't complete it. So students, just turn to page number 53, all of you. Turn to page number 53. Then we will go for the new chapter. That is chapter 6, the last dinosaurs. You know what is dinosaurs? Yes? You know dinosaurs? Have you seen? Where dinosaurs? Chapter 6, the last dinosaurs. The last dinosaurs. The last dinosaurs. Okay. So have you seen the dinosaurs?
Yes.
Who has seen? Yes, we have seen it in the movies. We have seen in the many English movies like Jurassic Park and many other movies. There are movies related to the dinosaurs, isn't it? But in real, we have not seen it. So students, as we begin the new chapter, chapter 6, the last dinosaurs. You know the meaning of dinosaurs. So what? Before we start the chapter, we have to know who has written it, who is the writer, and in which way he wrote it, and when he was born, then he is from where, all those things we have to write. Likewise, when you are studying in my class, you know my name, you know that from where I come, and you know that how strict I am in the classes, isn't it? So all these things you know. So same way, the chapter 6, we are starting the new chapter. We have to know who is the writer of this chapter. This is a beautiful story. This is a beautiful story about the dinosaurs. You will enjoy it, okay? You will enjoy it. So pay attention in the classes. So and when we have completed this, what will be the objective of this chapter? Objective, learning objective. What all things we will learn in this chapter? In this chapter, after the completion of the chapter, we will learn that we are able to understand about the dinosaurs. We are able to understand the concept of dinosaurs. Then we will able to read this chapter, and also we will able to understand the word meanings which are given in the chapter. So many things we can learn, and we will learn in this chapter. When we are dealing with the chapter, we will learn that how the punctuation marks, where the punctuation marks are used, all those things we will learn in this chapter. Okay students, so when we start the new chapter, some things we are going to discuss about the poet. We are trying to discuss about the poet. So before that, as we are speaking about the learning objective, isn't it? The learning objective we are speaking. So you can, after completion of this chapter, you can, of course, when I will ask anything, any question regarding this chapter, you will be able to answer it, isn't it? We will be able to answer. And then what else? We will speak about the fossils. We will be able to speak about the fossils, how the dinosaurs fossils were underground, how the dinosaurs fossils were laid for the hundreds or thousands of years. Then you will be able to form the form and use compound words. Then we will be able to form and use the compound words, learn about regular and irregular verbs, and change verbs from past to present or present to past. We will able to, then we will able to practice the punctuation marks. We will able to practice practice the pronunciation marks when we have completed this chapter. So let us start. Let us not waste our time and we move to the writer. Who is the writer of this chapter? The last dinosaur. The last dinosaur writer is the Pedro Pavel Sartiste. Pedro Pavel Sartiste. I write it like Pedro. Pedro Pavel. Pablo. Pedro Pablo Sartiste. 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 Okay. He is the writer of this chapter, this story. He is the writer. Then Pedro Pablo Sartiste was born in Madrid, Spain. He was born in the Spain in 1973. He was born in 1973. He was born in 1973. He is the second of six children. The Pedro Pablo Sartiste. They were six number of brothers and sisters in their family, and this the Pedro Pablo Sartiste was the second number child. As a child, he was very interested, but he ended up studying aeronautical engineering. So as a child, he had varied interests. Like when we are child, we have the many interests. We want to do this, we want to do that, we want to play this game, we want to play that game. Different kinds of the interest we have as a child. So same way, the writer, he had also different type of hobbies or different type of the interest he had when he was child. But as he grown up, he ended his studies of studying aeronautical engineering means those who study about the planes, aircrafts, the rockets, especially about the planes, which is the study of the design and science of aeroplanes and spacecraft. As I told, which was the study of aeroplane and spacecraft. So this person, this writer, the author, what is the name? Pedro Pablo Sartiste was an engineer. Which kind of engineer? He was the aeronautical engineer. Okay. So for years he worked in a big company, but realized that he loved writing story for children instead. Of course, he worked in many different companies, many big companies, but when he was working there, he realized that he can write the story better. He can write the story for the children. So his interest was in writing. So he started his project called Bedtime Story. At that time, he started to write the bedtime story. As our grandmas, grandpas, they tell us the story, not the bedtime story. And when we listen to it, slowly, we go to the sleep. Okay. So that is bedtime story. All of you might have heard the bedtime stories in the childhood, which include stories that are educational and instill important values. So the stories which he wrote, they were the educational and the valuable stories were there. Same way, The Last Dinosaurus is a small story about dinosaurs coming back to life, but in the most unusual way. Unusual means in different way, not usual way. Usual way, like human beings or the animals, they born, isn't it? So say, not that way, but these dinosaurs, they will be coming again to this world in unusual way. In the story, he will tell how the dinosaurs will come. So, Pedro loves writing such stories for children and has written several books. Many books he has written, several books such as Pedro's Fables, then Goofy Kids, The Camp, Waterlogged, then Chronicles and the Weirdo's Fables, Jungle Animals. So these are the famous book he has written. So this was the just introduction about the all the last dinosaurs. Okay, so students, we will move to the story. I am just reading the story and I will be going on explaining. Just to see the book at page number 54. At page number 54, all of you turn to the page number 54. There you will see the story begins. I will read the story, then I will explain. If the any difficult words are there, I will try to explain that also. So you have to also keep the pencil with you, and whatever the words you find difficult, you can ask it. Okay, you can ask it. Okay, so students, as I was discussing about the chapter, we will continue reading and we will try to understand. Okay, so let us start at page number 54. All of you turn. In a lush land of tropical forest, on top of the only mountain in the region, trapped inside an old volcanic crater system, lived the last group of large ferocious dinosaurs. So this is in a lost land. Lost land, that land is lost. We do not know about the land. We are not aware about the land. That is known as lost land. So tropical forest. Tropical means, what do you understand by tropical? Tropical means near the equator. Tropical means the Ushnakatibandh. In Hindi, if you understand, we say that Ushnakatibandh. Ushnakatibandh, that is the Hindi name of that place. That is, we are not aware about the places. That is tropical forest, on top of the only mountain in the region, trapped inside an old volcanic crater system, and which is trapped inside the old volcano, you know, where the volcano comes up, there it can be made as a mountain, a big mountain, because volcano is very hot and ashes and many things comes out from the land. So there it can make a mountain. So same way, when the volcanoes, here it is set inside a volcano crater system. So when volcano covers the land or the empty place, that becomes a what? Mountain, like mountain. Leave the last ever group of large ferocious dinosaurs. So ferocious dinosaurs, they lived in that volcano, the writer is saying. For thousands and thousands of years, they had survived all the changes on earth. And in that volcano, inside that crater, that these group of large ferocious dinosaurs, they lived for thousands and thousands of years. They had survived all the changes in earth. Whatever the changes, it may be the summer, it may be the winter, it may be the rainy season, it may be the hot, it may be the cold. So all these seasons they have survived change on earth, many changes, that is in the earth they have survived there. And now let the great ferocious, led by the ferocious, they were planning to come out of hiding and dominate the world once more. In the olden time, as we see in the movies, that these dinosaurs, the very large animal, they were dominating the world. In that ancient time, there were no human beings, only the animals, and this dinosaurus was the one of the largest animal in the world in the ancient time, as we see in the movies. It is called first, and we knew from the movie. Okay, so here we are speaking about the dinosaurus, how they will be coming, hiding, and to one more time, they will dominate means to overcome. Dominate means overcome with some strength, that is dominant. Okay, the volcanic crater, you know, ferocious, you know, the ferocious is cruel, capable of violence, very cruel. So they are, these dinosaurs are very cruel. Then Cresiosaurus was an awesome Tyrannosaurus Rex who had decided they had spent too much time isolated from the rest of the world. So these, the awesome Rex who had decided they had spent too much time isolated. So these dinosaurs, they were isolated. Isolated, you know, this day isolation is very common one. Why? Because of the COVID-19. Isolation means remaining one. So whoever is having the COVID-19, whoever is having the coronavirus, he has to be isolated. He has to be isolated because he can spread the disease in others. That is why the doctors, the WHO guideline is given that the one who is facing the coronavirus, the COVID-19, he has to be isolated by himself. So isolated means remaining alone. So same way these dinosaurs, they were remaining alone in the forest. They were in that volcanic crater, they were alone, isolated from the rest of the world. They all were isolated from the rest of the world. Okay. So students, as I was speaking that these dinosaurs, they were isolated in the volcano, and they were separated. They were separate from the rest of the world. So over a few years, the dinosaurs walked together. So over the few years, these dinosaurs, they walked together. How? Demolition. Isn't it? Yes. Demolishing the walls of the crater. When the work was done, all the dinosaurs carefully sharpened their claws and teeth in readiness to terrorize the world once again. So now these dinosaurs, they again want to come in the world. To make the demolish the walls of the great crater. When their work was done, all the dinosaurs carefully sharpened their claws and teeth. They have the sharp teeth. So during this thousands of years, what they did? They sharpened their teeth. They sharpened their claws. Okay, claws and teeth in readiness to terrorize the world once again. Terrorize means they want to make the afraid the world. They want to afraid. On leaving their home of thousands of years, everything was new for them. When suppose we are born in a place, suppose I am born in the Korba, and for many years I go to live in the different, any other cities or any other state or any other countries. Suppose I am born in India, I am an Indian, and I go to America for 10 to 20 years, for 10-20 years. When I come back and I will see that India has been changed, it has been developed in various ways. So same way, these dinosaurs, they were inside the volcanic crater for thousands and thousands of years, and now when they are coming back, they will see the changes, they will see the new world. On leaving their home of thousands of years, everything was new to them. So after the thousands of years, they are coming back. So that was new for them, very different to what they had been used to inside the crater. So very different with the inside the crater, inside the volcanic crater, it was different situation. And when they are coming out from that crater, so this the land, the world is different for them, different situation. However, for days the dinosaurs continue to resolute. However, the dinosaurs, they started resolute. Resolute means to set your mind in the something. So they took time to set their mind in the world. They took time, the leader. Finally, from the top of some mountains, they saw a small town. From top of this mountains, when they are coming out from the volcanic crater, on the top of the mountain, from there they see the small town. Small town they see. When we are up in the very high place, we will see that this land, some of the plants, small plants, they are not visible. They will be looking as they are a grass. For the human beings, they will be looking as a little ants. So their size is small from the smaller from the higher places. So same way, these dinosaurs, when they looked from the mountain to this small on the land, on the ground, so they, what they see, they saw a small town. Its houses and town for seemed like tiny dots. They were seen like tiny dots. Never having seen human beings before, so never having seen the human beings before. What they are doing? Never have you seen the animal, the human beings before. At that time, when in the ancient time, the animals were there and the dinosaurs were there. At that time, the human beings were not there. So this is the first time they are seeing the human beings before. The dinosaurs leaped down the mountain side, ready to destroy anything that stood in their way. And now they are ready to destroy anything comes in their way. If the animal comes, they will destroy it. If the human beings come on their way, they will destroy that also. They will destroy that also. So, ready to destroy anything that stood in their way. However, as they approached that little town, the houses were getting bigger and bigger. When from the far away they saw the towns were looking like a tiny dot, now when they are coming closer and closer, there the houses size are growing bigger and bigger. And when the dinosaurs finally arrived, what happened? It turned out that the houses were much bigger than the dinosaurs themselves. So at this time, when you will see the in many metro cities like Delhi, Mumbai, the houses are really 20 stories, 30 stories, 35 stories, buildings are huge, buildings are there. So now if the dinosaurs comes in this time, during this time, they will see the houses are much bigger than themselves, and the dinosaurs much bigger than the dinosaurs themselves. As boy was passing by, said, nowadays you see the boys, they play with the dinosaur. They play with the dinosaurs means the small dinosaurs. You might have seen the plastic dinosaurs, then which is made as a craft, Daddy, I have found some tiny dinosaurs. Can I eat them? So you people, you children, what will you say? You will say to your parents, you will say to your daddy, I have found a dinosaurus. Can I keep this dinosaurus? So this way you can say, okay. But in the olden times, the dinosaurus was very huge. The animal, the user, the bigger than any other animals. So and such is like the terrifying Crocius and his friends ended up as pet for the village children. And now the dinosaurus, they are pet for the village children. Seeing how millions of years of evolution had turned their species into miniature. Species into miniature dinosaurs. They learned that miniature lasted forever and that you must always be ready to adapt. You must always ready to adapt the situation. So this is students, in the beginning of the video the videos may be not clear, but because the camera was in the different mood while making the video, and now it is in the different mood. So you will maybe in the beginning that is difficult to see for you, but slowly the videos will be clear for you. Okay, so watch the complete video, and this is the completion of the chapter. The word meanings you have to learn. The word meanings, homework for you. Homework. Write, learn. The homework for you, all of you note down the homework and listen. Go through the chapter once again, read the chapters, read it very loudly when you have the time at your home. When you read loudly, what happens? We inculcate the confidence, we develop our confidence, and when we read loudly, we also our voice becomes clear and our hesitations that goes away. So I request you, when you are at home, you read loudly so that your parents can listen, your elders can listen. Okay. If you are making any mistakes, they can guide you. Otherwise, if you are reading slowly, nothing, like this way, in lost land or tropical forest, this is not the way. Read it properly, read it very loudly. Okay. So that others can listen and others can correct. Read very loudly, louder. Okay. So students, the homework is for you. Learn and write word meaning of page number 54 and page number 55. There also one word meaning is there. That is the meaning of a very small person of things. That is miniature. That is there. So these the word meanings you have to learn and write. Okay, so note down the homework. Okay, now let us end our class. Today we end our class. The chapter 6 has been completed. The question answers we will do in the next class. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.